Good morning, students. Hope I am audible to you and you are getting my screen. If in between you will not get my voice or screen, just unmute yourself and tell me in between, okay? If you are having any problem. So, from last lecture, we have started with a new topic and a new section. Like in our first section, we have gone for basic part of plastic engineering and some of the basics of design of simple plastic component, right? As I told, mostly the plastic components are preferred where there is no any such issue of high stresses, high temperature, or extreme conditions are not there, okay? In the normal condition, in the normal application, plastic is preferred for the different applications. Getting it, okay? And a design of part becomes complicated when that particular component, when that particular element is exposed to extreme condition. Okay, extreme condition in terms of anything, in terms of stresses, loads, strains, temperature, pressure, or any other chemical conditions also. Okay, so just a minute. So, it depends on that conditions where that component is exposed, right? And based on that conditions only the component is designed, okay? The component is designed, okay? A simple example, if I were to give SUVs, MUVs, okay? So whatever the sedan cars, like high profile cars are there, vehicles, four wheelers, okay? Their designing parameters are different. And the vehicles which are used in villages for carrying the load, or in the poor road conditions, where there are poor road conditions, the vehicles which are used at that conditions, in the poor road conditions, are designed differently, okay, by considering different stresses, different loads, different atmospheric conditions. And the vehicles which are going to be used in the metro cities only, okay, like their clearance, ground clearance is everything is going to be different. Okay, so what I want to tell at the end, that this designing depends on the conditions or the parameters for where we are going to use that component. Okay, so application point of view is the most important. Okay, so based on that, if you think about the plastic components, the applications of the plastic, or the plastic is mostly used where these extreme conditions are not there. Simple PET bottles, okay, just like carbonated drinks bottles, caps, syrup bottles, tablet cases, tables, furniture, chairs, laptop cases, delicate things, okay, where there is no any such huge stress or huge load, okay? So that designing of the component is easy. Designing of the component is easy, and we have not considered so many parameters. There is a failures and different kind of constants and all that, okay? Simple thing, just calculating the stresses, calculating the dimension is the only part, right? So that designing of the component is quite easy, okay? But apart from a component, we have to focus on the mold also, because ultimately, see, calculation part may be the easy, but manufacturing is going to be quite difficult, because see, how the part is going to be there at the end, it depends on the process of molding. It depends on the process of molding rather than process of design. Getting it, okay? So, rather than component, mold design becomes more important. Mold design becomes more important, okay? So, entire second section is devoted for the mold design, okay? And based on that, some component designs also, okay? Simple one. So, we have started with the, first of all, compression molding process, or the compression mold. Because compression mold is widely used for different applications or the different plastic components, so that we have gone for the major one, compression molding, and along with compression there will be transfer molding also. Compression molding and then injection molding, which are popular, okay? So we have started with the compression mold first of all, right? And in the last layer, we have seen the molding, okay? Specifically, yesterday I told you why there is a requirement of mold heating, right? So the first thing you will have to clear, that in case of compression molding process, the process already we have seen in the first section. कॉम्प्रेशन मोल्डिंग प्रेशर, सॉरी इन कॉम्प्रेशन मोल्डिंग प्रोसेस वी आर अप्लाइंग ह्यूज प्रेशर, वी आर अप्लाइंग द ह्यूज प्रेशर एज कम्पेयर टू इंजेक्शन मोल्डिंग. ओके द सिंपल एग्जाम्पल आई हैव गिवन यू द ब्रिक मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. ओके इट मेनली डिपेंड्स ऑन द प्रेशर रादर दैन अ टेम्परेचर पैरामीटर, गेटिंग इट. ओके प्रेशराइजिंग द मोल्डन मटेरियल और सेमी सॉलिड सेमी लिक्विड मटेरियल टू गेट द डिजायर्ड शेप, दैट इज द प्रोसेस फॉर द कॉम्प्रेशन मोल्डिंग. ओके सो प्रेशर मेक्स, प्रेशर प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल रादर दैन अ टेम्परेचर. ऑब्वियसली टेम्परेचर और हीटिंग विल बी ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्ड. ओके सो नाउ सी materials used in case of compression molding or the components which are manufactured through the compression molding are also of that kind where the maximum pressure is required, where quite good strength in the component is required. Okay so mostly the thermosetting materials are there in case of compression molding, because I told you in case of thermosetting material heating will cause setting of the material, heating will cause setting of the material. Okay and that will not be a preferred in a injection molding, because injection molding the temperature levels are very high, it is passed through the barrels, through the nozzles, so there is a possibility that it will settle in that passage only, in that passage only. Okay so we want such a kind of mold design, such a kind of process where complications are less. Setup is a simple, you can easily remove, you can easily pour the material. Okay so that compression molding is preferred. Told in case of thermosetting material, heating will cause freezing. Heating will cause freezing, freezing or setting. Okay, so in such cases, there should be a less role of heat, and there should be more role of pressure. Okay, and it occurs, it happens in case of compression mold, so that this thermosetting materials are preferred in a compression molding. Okay so we have gone for the mold heating, I told you the reason of mold heating also. So basically in case of mold heating temperature, pressure and cure time. Okay mold heating in the sense what we are doing already, the material is coming into the mold cavity, that material is already in a heated condition. Okay when heated material is coming inside the mold cavity, which is at the atmospheric temperature, means material temperature is suppose for example 80 degree Celsius and the atmospheric temperature is a very less 30 degree Celsius, so there is a very huge temperature difference and heat decay will occur very fastly, heat decay will occur very fastly, and because of that we will not get the proper component, proper density, uniform texture, uniform surface, uniform properties. To maintain the uniformity, cooling should be in a gradual way, it should not be a steep, it should not be a very fast. Okay and see, to occupy each and every location in the mold cavity, if suppose product is a complex, it is having so many small shapes. Okay so it needs that that liquid molten material should occupy each and every space. When it is possible, it is possible when there is a good flowability of the material, right? And flowability can be achieved by using the heating the material. Okay you may be have the question that if you will heat the material, it is possibility that there is a possibility that it will settle down, but we are not heating to that extent whereby it will settle. Okay so not low temperature, not high temperature. Okay by using optimum heating we are going for this mold heating. Okay then we have seen that what will happen if there will be a heating at extreme level, either high temperature or the lower temperature. High temperature will cause loss of properties or pre-curing or burn spot, and lower temperature will cause less flowability or incomplete curing. Then we have seen the parameters on which this mold temperature level depends. The first one, material for mold, material for component, and the geometry. And the geometry, because see, if geometry is a very simple, so it don't require that material doesn't require to occupy each and every space. It will automatically flow, it will easily occupy all the spaces if geometry will not complicated. Okay, in that cases temperature level will be different, and where there is a very intricate shapes are there, complex shapes are there, material required good flowability. Okay, and that time the temperature requirement will be different. Okay, so it depends on material of mold, material of component, and the geometry or the sizing of the component. Right, so mold heating is carried out by three ways: electrical, steam, hot water. I told you, steam and hot water easy to carry out, but controlling will be difficult. Controlling will be difficult. Okay, because see, steam and hot water, the first thing is that this generation of steam, generation of hot water requires large setup. Okay, again, whenever hot water will be circulated around the mold, there will be the heat transfer, so temperature of hot water will goes down. Again, we have to recirculate that water to the setup and heat that water, and again, like an heat exchanger, for example, like an heat exchanger. Okay, continuous circulation, getting it. Okay, so there is a huge setup is required. Steam also same case, but in case of electrical, simple induction heating or the resistance heating or even simple induction heating will heat the mold easily. And if you have the sensors, controllers, you can easily control the heat. Like because see, electrical appliances, we are easily controlling. We are controlling it easily by using simple knobs, buttons, switches. Okay, that way we can control the electricity, and in turn we can control the heating. Okay, and we have summarized some points also. If you want even equal heating at all the places, there should not be uneven distribution, so that electrical will be the best. Then we have seen the modes of heat losses, because we are heating the mold to compensate these heat losses. So that there are three modes of heat losses: by conduction, by convection, by radiation. Okay, now just a minute. Okay, heating we have seen, mold heating we have seen. Okay, and you got the purpose also. Simple purpose should be have, we should get, or we want good flowability, good consistency, uniform density. Okay, uniform properties. To get these things, we are heating the mold. Okay, second thing, now whenever this liquid or semi-solid material is coming inside the mold cavity, it is in a heated condition. Mold is also in a heated condition. Okay, now what happens, see, already this plastic is a chemical based material. Mostly this condition doesn't happen with the this venting is not required mostly in case of metallic materials. Okay, the reason is that that chemical inertness is there in case of metallic material, but in case of plastic, this because of instability or because of the chemical nature, we require this vent. Now what happens when this heated material is coming inside the mold cavity? Okay, so there is a possibility of the reactions, chemical reactions. Okay, even the heating will also generate the gases. Okay, it will generate the gases. So when this material will come inside the, it will come inside the mold cavity, chemical reaction generally occurs. It will generate gases. It will generate gases. Okay, the hot gases. Okay, because of this heated condition of the material. Now these gases can generate, maybe because of reaction of material, plastic material with mold material, maybe with the surface of the mold, maybe with itself also. Okay, so many reasons, but the thing is that because of heated condition, the chemical reaction will occur and gases will generate. Okay, now a simple thing, if gases will be there inside closed cavity, what will happen? If gases will be there inside closed cavity, getting it? Okay, now this you have studied in your manufacturing process also. Okay, see, if gases will be there inside the mold cavity, these gases will try to escape from it. It will try to escape from it because of pressure inside the cavity. Because of the pressure inside the cavity, and already it is closed. So the gases will start to escape. Now, while escaping through the mold, they will trace a path from the component. Are you getting my view? What is happening? Whenever these gases will try to escape from the mold, it will trace or it will generate a path through the component. It will generate a path through the component. Okay. So, generate a path means what? It will create an void. It will create an opening inside the component. Simple example, I will use sponge. Okay. Or we have a sponge. Have you checked the sponge? When you will put that sponge inside the water, it will soak the water. It will absorb the water. Okay. Why it is absorbing the water? Because cavities are there. Cavities are there. Similar kind of cavities or voids are created inside the component because the gases will trace a path. They will try to escape. While escaping, they will generate a path or a void or that space. Okay. And what will happen now? Simple thing. We will not get a uniform density in the component. We will not get uniform density in the component. And already I told you, whenever there are such voids, there is a possibility of generating, there is a possibility of generating cracks. Because cracks are propagated from the voids. Cracks are propagated from the voids. Okay. So distortion may possible. Distortion may possible. Okay. So this is the first thing. Okay. So that because of these gases, we require venting system. Okay. We require simple thing, simple word, ventilation. We required simple ventilation so that these gases will easily taken out from the mold cavity. It will easily taken out from the mold cavity. Have you got the reason why this is required to taken out from the mold cavity? Because it will disturb the product. It will disturb the product. Okay. Gas or air act as pocket, creating voids. Okay. Like, see. If you have seen flowing water, like in your farm, if you have seen the transparent flexible plastic pipes. Nowadays, apart from PVC pipe, there are foldable plastic pipes are also there, transparent. Okay, you have seen that. Whenever we require for a temporary condition, we are using that. This foldable, transparent plastic pipes to carry the water. If you check that water flowing from the particular pipe, there are some air pockets, bubbles are there. Okay, whenever water is flowing, you will see that bubbles. What is that bubbles? That bubbles are nothing but air pockets. And bubbles are nothing but the air pockets. And might be, I think, in your fluid mechanics, you have studied the concept of cavitation and pitching. Cavitation and pitching. Okay, what happens? This bubble will strike on the pipe surface and it will burst. And that is called as a pitching. Okay, if you touch that pipe, you will see these vibrations. That is because of this voids which are busting on the surface of the pipe, inside surface of the pipe. Okay, forget. So this is nothing but the where it went. Okay, this is nothing but the air pockets or gas pockets or air pockets. Again, one more thing is that while closing the mold, there is a possibility that second possibility I am telling. There is a possibility that atmospheric air will trap inside the mold. See, actually at the start it is open to the atmosphere while pouring, and then we are closing it. While closing, possibility of trapping the atmospheric air inside the cavity. There is also possibility. Okay. So this is second possibility. One is a first is a first one is a generation of gases. Second is a trapped air. Okay. So this will both of these factors will what I can say it will impact the quality of the product. It will impact the quality of the product. Okay. And the last point also it is shown here. Have you seen this? इफ द गैसेस आर नॉट अलाउड एस्केप थ्रू द वेंट्स दे मे ऑक्सीडाइज द ल्यूब्रिकेंट्स लिविंग बर्न मार्क्स ऑन द पार्ट. ओके, व्हाट इज हैपनिंग? सी, वी हैव अप्लाइड ल्यूब्रिकेशन इनसाइड द मोल्ड कैविटी ऑल्सो, ओके, इनसाइड द पैसेज ऑल्सो वेल पासिंग द लिक्विड मटेरियल. ओके, बिकॉज ल्यूब्रिकेशन इज अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस मोल्डिंग प्रोसेस फॉर इजी इजैक्युलेशन ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट एंड सो मेनी रीजन्स. सो वॉट विल हैपन, दिस हीटेड एक्चुअली नाउ दिस गैसेस आर नॉट इन अ रूम टेम्परेचर, दिस गैसेस आर एट द वेरी हाई टेम्परेचर. सो दिस गैसेस विल एक्ट ऑन दिस ल्यूब्रिकंट्स एंड दिस इट विल ऑक्सीडाइज, इट विल बर्न डाउन दैट ल्यूब्रिकंट एंड लाइक इट विल क्रिएट अ स्पॉट, इट विल क्रिएट अ बर्निंग स्पॉट, इट विल क्रिएट अ बर्निंग स्पॉट ऑन द कंपोनेंट सर्फेस. ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ बर्न मार्क्स, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ बर्न मार्क्स. ओके, सो दैट इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल इनसाइड द मोल्ड कैविटी. ओके, सो दिस मेनी रीजन्स आर दियर, दिस मेनी रीजन्स आर दियर वाई वी नीड वेंटिलेशन और द मोल्ड वेंट्स. सिंपल रीजन, टू एस्केप द ट्रैप्ड एयर और गैसेस. ओके, now to taken out that air or trapped air or gases, we have two options to remove that particular air or gases. Okay, the first one, and just keep it in mind these words, mold breath. Okay, so mold breath means what? Mold breath means we are allowing this mold to breathe. Okay, so simple example I'll give you. If you are sitting it in a closed room, okay, and after some time you may be feeling suffocation inside the closed room, okay, because of this it will not have a proper ventilation. Okay, you will start getting suffocation, you will feel the suffocation, right? Now in that case what happens? To breathe properly, what you will do, you will go outside the room and you will be exposed to the atmospheric air, getting it, and breathing will again start properly. Okay, so what you are doing, you are opening yourself or you are exposing yourself towards atmospheric air for some time. Okay, same way we are doing here, that is called as a mold breathing. What is happening? Mold is generally is a totally 100% closed condition. Okay, so that in our regular word, if you want to say, suffocation will happen. Okay, so mold breathing means what? Generally, what happens? General condition, mold cavity at the start in opening open condition, pour that molten material inside the mold cavity, close it completely, allow it to cool, and then open it and remove the product. Okay, that's what the process. So we are removing the product at the end. Before that, we are not opening any part of the mold. Okay, so here what is happening in the mold breath? When you will pour molten material inside the cavity, so in between this process, before cooling and after pouring the molten material, you will have to open that mold, very small opening. Okay, what is given here, 3 mm, open it for 3 mm space, only that much, very small opening, open it and immediately close it. So what will happen? Whatever the trapped air or gases will be there, it will be taken out from that, it will easily escape from that opening. Okay, that is called as a mold breathing. Now maybe you will have thought that it may not be sometime possible, because 3 mm, that is a small opening, and immediately closing it, it's quite difficult. Okay, but it is one of the option. It is called as a mold breathing. Okay, so opening it for some time and then immediately closing it. Okay, so that is called as a mold breathing. And the second one is mold vent or opening, mold vent or mold ventilation or mold opening. Okay, so here what is actually happening, we are providing ventilation to the mold, we are providing passage for that gases, we are providing passage for that gases. Okay, now see, ऑलरेडी बिकॉज ऑफ दिस प्रोडक्ट इफ यू सी द मोल्ड डिजाइन इज आर वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. सो मेनी पार्ट्स आर देयर, स्प्रू एंड गेटिंग सिस्टम एंड पार्टिंग लाइन, कैविटीज, मोल्ड सरफेस, वॉल थिकनेस, ड्राफ्ट, अंडरकट, सो मेनी थिंग्स आर देयर. ओके, सो वॉट यू विल टू डू व्हाइल डिजाइनिंग द मोल्ड, सम स्पेस इज प्रोवाइडेड, वेरी स्मॉल स्पेस, सम स्पेस इज प्रोवाइडेड टू एस्केप द गैसेस. Just it is to be the care is to be taken that through that cavity molten material should not come out. Getting it? Okay. Through that cavity molten material should not come out. Okay. So that these openings are provided at the particular locations only, mostly at the parting surface, mostly at the parting surface. Okay. And number of how many number of vents are required depends on the viscosity of material. Depends on the viscosity or the type of material that is used for the component manufacturing. Okay, now generally this is the sizing, like it should be 0.02 to 0.25 millimeter deep, 3 to 6 millimeter wide, and up to 25 millimeter long. A general recommendation, okay, mostly followed. So it depends, the range depends on the type of material, type of mold, size of mold. Okay, because it will decide the nature of gases, nature of air trapped. Okay, now where it went. This one. It is important that all vents must lead to the atmosphere. Otherwise, the vent will be useless. Okay, obvious. Okay, so the opening of the mold should be exposed to the, or it should be facing the atmosphere. It should be facing the atmosphere. Otherwise, it should not open inside somewhere. Otherwise, again the gases will be trapped. Okay, so ultimately the opening should go to the, or this opening should face to the, one end should face to the atmospheric air. Now this. Again, with respect to this dimension and this statement, what care is to be required? Now, thing is that, as I told the concept of cavitation also, I told that you may have studied in fluid mechanics, cavitation. Now, what happens actually, if the pressure of the gas or if the pressure of the air which is trapped inside the mold cavity, listen carefully. If the pressure of gases or the pressure of air trapped inside the mold cavity is less than atmospheric pressure, then simple thing, though you will provide any number of vents, the gases or trapped air will not pass to the atmosphere. Simple thing, because see, what is your rule of the potential energy? Okay, it flows from high potential to low potential. Similar way, it will flow, the gases will flow only when pressure of trapped air, pressure of trapped gases will more than atmospheric pressure, okay, getting it? Okay, and then only this gases or air will automatically moved away from the mold cavity. See, we are not physically doing anything to remove the gases. We are just providing opening or the space for the passage of gases. We cannot do anything manually. We cannot pressurize it separately. Okay, it will become so much complicated. So it should automatically come out from the mold cavity to the atmosphere. And for that, why this dimensioning is required? For that, this dimensioning is required to follow. Now, simple question. How the pressure and dimensioning are related? Just take the example. You are holding one rubber pipe in your hand, which is connected. Another end is connected to the motor, okay, or pump. Okay. And you are not, you are just hold that particular pipe and you will start that pump. And water will start spilling out from the pipe. Okay, now what you will do? this is a flexible pipe, okay? You are holding one end of the pipe. Do one thing, just close some part of opening of that particular pipe. Just close some part of opening of that particular pipe with your thumb. What will happen? The water will be forced to along. Okay, it will go very long. So what we are doing generally, like while cleaning your vehicles, while cleaning your two-wheeler or cycle, what you are doing? You are holding the pipe and you are pressure. You are putting your thumb in front of that opening. So you are closing some part of that pipe. You are closing some part of pipe and you are keeping it very small opening. So it is generating the pressure. It is generating the pressure, and that pressure generated is converted into kinetic energy. Because of that, that water is forced to a long distance, okay? Or it will be ejaculated with the spilling will be with the very high pressure, okay? Or you just check garage also. They are cleaning the vehicles, and if you check the pipe of that, they have attached the nozzle. Usually they attach nozzle at the end of the pipe, okay? Because of that, they are getting the pressure, okay? So as you change the dimension, a simple funda, there is a formula in your fluid mechanics. Capital Q is equal to AV, flow rate, volume flow rate is equal to area into velocity of the liquid, okay? So simple thing, if you decrease the area, velocity will increase. Getting it, okay? So same way, okay? So that dimensioning is a very important. That dimensioning will decide the pressure generation inside the cavity or inside that space provided. And because of that only, there is a chances of getting or taking out the gases out from the mold cavity, okay? Got the meaning why we are providing this specific dimension? Because this dimensioning will allow to generate a proper pressure, okay? And what is the last? Whenever possible, vents should be located in the movable half of the mold. Okay, obviously, the vents are provided mostly at the parting line or at the movable part. Getting it? So that whenever we are moving, the gases can be easily escaped. Okay, here you can see it properly. Right. I'll zoom it. Are you getting this? Three openings are provided. Vent channels. Okay. Through that vent channel, the gases will escape. Through that vent channel, these gases will escape. Okay. Only aim is that that gases should leave the mold cavity. Then easily it can be passed from the remaining mold part. Okay. Only thing is that it should leave that mold cavity where exact part is there. Right. So that's how this mold vents are provided. Okay. Number of vents, even size of vent depends on the size of vent decides the pressure, but number of vents depends on the material that is used for manufacturing of the component, okay? Because that will decide what kind of gases, even the dimensions or geometry of the component, that will in case of generation of gases. Got the meaning? Okay, so that's why this is required, okay? So this is the mold venting. Have you got the meaning now? Simple, you should be able to explain each and everything now. You should just if you once get, you will get the reason why we are going for this, you can easily explain, okay? So mold venting is simply to remove the trapped air or gases generated from the mold cavity, okay? Okay, so otherwise it will have impact on the product. It will have impact on the product. Okay, so that is the thing. Okay, again, one more issue is there. Sometimes it happens. If suppose gases generated will be more, and the pressure of the gases is also more, there is a possibility that these gases will force the mold, or these gases will force molten material to displace from its original location. So what will happen? So whatever shape we have desired, we will not get that shape. Are you getting? दिस प्रेशराइज्ड गैसेस, हाई प्रेशर हाई टेम्परेचर गैसेस विल फोर्स मोल्टन मटेरियल टू डिस्प्लेस फ्रॉम इट्स वन लोकेशन टू अनदर लोकेशन, सो विल नॉट गेट अल्टीमेटली द डिजायर्ड शेप एंड साइज ऑफ द कंपोनेंट. ओके, दिस इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल. थर्ड थिंग, if this is a continuous process, mostly these are continuous process, okay, in the mass production, so this high pressurized gases, whenever it are, these are impacting on the mold internal surface of the mold, so if this frequency is more, if this frequency will be more, there is a possibility of generating cracks inside the mold surface because of the continuous high pressure gases, because of the continuous impact of the high pressure gases. Okay, so these many things are there, these many things are there because of this gases or the air. Okay, and to remove that gases and air, we need to have this mold vents, we need to have this mold vent. Okay, so these are the, some basic parameters. Okay, actually these are important one, just a minute. Okay, so basically these two parameters are important, one mold heating and mold venting. Okay, before going for design of the mold, right, so just keep it in mind, the basic things, this two methods are available, mold breathing, mold vent, why we are going for mold venting, what happens inside the mold cavity actually because of the hot gases, and then mold heating. Okay, the modes, the media, then factors responsible for that, and what happens if temperature range will not be proper. Okay, so this two parameters are important, so that it is taken at in the start. Okay, it has taken in the start, and now from next lecture onwards we can start with the actual design aspects and basic parameters required for the compression molding. Okay, yes, so just a minute. Right, I'll take the attendance, and do not leave the session. Number 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20, 23, 25, 29, 34, 35, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 49, 50, 51, 55, 57, 58, 60, 62, 64, 65, 68, 72, 73, 77. Okay, I think it is over. Okay, so maybe by today or by tomorrow I'll share you the ISE first score, and maybe possibly the yesterday's test score also. Okay, so and one more thing I want to share here, that just take care of yourself and your family just keep it in always mind one thing that always, whenever it will be in future or anytime, the life is the prime importance, or your life, your family life, okay? The money, position, education, everything comes later, okay? The first thing which is the most important is your life. Your health is the most important one. So whatever the things happened in the last year was not that critical, but whatever things are happening nowadays are so critical, okay? And you know the situation, even our basic infrastructure required for to fight such kind of situation is not good. Even we don't have the proper medical facilities. We all are living in villages, so that is again major issue. Even metro peoples are facing the issues. So there will be a very difficult situation in the villages also, okay? So just take care, don't come outside, okay? Don't leave your without any reason, don't come outside, okay? Your friends, your anything, relatives, etc., leave it for time, okay? And don't take it casually, because I have seen the situation, what happens when someone get this corona disease, okay? I have seen it yesterday also. It is a very, very difficult, okay? Last time the problem was not regarding the breathing, okay? The major issue is that, see, whatever happen, if it will happen physically with other parts like backache, body ache, headache, that we can easily heal that. But when it comes to the heart, lungs, kidneys, it is very difficult to cure that. It is very difficult to call the cure that. Costing, we are not thinking at all. Costing is a very, very difficult issue. Okay. So, but whenever it comes to the internal organs, it becomes very critical. Last time it was not so much related to the or internal issues like lungs and kidneys and etc. Okay. But this time it has directly attacked on the internal organs. Okay. You know the things. This last time breathing was not in a picture. Breathing was not an issue. Okay. Cough and fever. And some kind of vomiting, that was only issue. Now this time, along with that, this body pain and failure of internal organs, breathing issue is very critical. Because last time you may have seen, this case was not there, the requirement of oxygen. We have not seen the need of oxygen at that level, okay? But this time, the things are changed suddenly, okay? So very difficult to come out from this situation. You should physically and mentally fit. Along with that, you will have to take care of your parents, your brother, your sister, your relatives, okay? So I'm telling this because I have seen this situation, okay? If you have checked yesterday, there was one news from the Pune, right? Entire family has now, it is no more. Entire family, only two people are remaining, okay? Entire family. So you can think the situation, okay? Today's morning, if you see the news, many of the people have died just because of insufficient supply of the oxygen, okay? The death count is daily, now it has crossed 1500, and situation is becoming worse. Still, the actual numbers are not out. Let this election of West Bengal, once this election will complete, West Bengal election, just see the numbers. Just see the numbers, okay? You will get the exact picture. So very difficult situation, okay? I'm taking this time to tell you because very, very worst situation. We have never faced this kind of situation in last more than 1,000 years, okay? So take care of yourself, your family, be careful, okay? If you are having any problem anytime, be in touch with us. If you need anything, okay? Not just with respect to this our academic part, okay? This is going to be there always, but personally, if you need anything, any help, okay, just be in touch with your faculty or be in touch with your me, okay? If you need any kind of help, okay? So take care. Possibly I think still that electric supply is not there, okay? Just check your WhatsApp group. I think lecture may not be there, okay? HMT lecture, okay? So thank you so much for joining. Take care of you, take care of your family. Have a nice day. Okay, you can leave the session now.